Victoria has been smashed by fierce winds, heavy rains and hail the size of golf balls as severe thunderstorms swept across the state, leaving thousands without power. Large swathes of the state have been hit by power outages, with up to 25,000 people still without power across regional areas. To see your local weather, go to the top of the website and tap your postcode into the section Your Location or visit the weather page here. About 20,000 PowerCorp and City Power customers in areas like Mildura, Bendigo, Shepparton, Cobram and Kyoto still have no power. There are 5815 AusIt customers also blacked out, with areas around Glorowart and Kilmore the hardest hit. SES volunteers responded to more than 1,000 call-outs, mostly in Mildura, Bendigo, Kilmore, Swan Hill and Shepparton, as wind speeds reached 100 km per hour in some areas. Temperatures in Melbourne dropped 12 degrees in just 10 minutes yesterday afternoon as the storm descended on the city, with flash flooding hitting parts of the CBD. A landslide in Surry Hills, east of Melbourne, has damaged close to 30 metres of footpath along Warrigal Road, which has been closed as emergency service work to clean up the area. It's understood the road will not be reopened in time for peak hour traffic this morning. Video sent to 9 News shows streets turned to rivers, huge hailstones and even a trampoline sent flying through a roof at Waller. 3 to 4 centimetres of hail had been reported in Erwaddig and East Doncaster. A pool in Doncaster turned into a wave pool as it was pelted by hail, while a lightning strike in Mill Park caused a tree to explode into flames. The SES has received more than 700 calls for help, mostly in Mildura, Bendigo, Kilmore, Swan Hill and Shepparton, and more than 100,000 properties were left without electricity for much of the night. Most of the damage has been to buildings, along with fallen trees and power lines. More than 20 millimetres of rain fell in Melbourne in just 20 minutes. The arrival of a cold front sparked severe thunderstorm warnings for much of the state, as winds of more than 100 kilometres per hour hit some areas. Read more, your Christmas long weekend forecast. In Mildura in the state's northwest, destructive winds caused damage to a number of buildings. Winds of up to 125 kilometres per hour are also expected for some coastal areas. Copyright 9 Digital Proprietary Limited 2017.